Good day to you. You're welcome to RCCG New Covenant Parish's Open Heavens Daily Devotional. The Open Heavens Daily Devotional is written by our Father and Lord, the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Pastor Iye Adeboye. And I pray that as you've joined me today, God will bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. Today, 13th May 2021, we'll be looking at the topic, Hearken Unto God. I'll be taking a memory verse from the book of Mark chapter 14 verse 38, which says, "Watch ye and pray, lest ye enter into temptation. The spirit truly is ready, but the flesh is weak." We'll be taking our Bible text from Mark chapter 14 from verses 37 to 38, which says, "And he cometh and findeth them sleeping, and saith unto Peter, Simon, sleepest thou? Couldest thou not watch 1 hour? Watch ye and pray, lest ye enter into temptation. The spirit truly is ready, but the flesh is weak." It is always good to pay close attention to instructions given by anyone you consider to be your guide or guardian. More often, we miss many opportunities, breakthroughs, and victories because we fail to pay attention to the details of the instructions given to us. The apostles of old also struggled with this lack of adequate attention to detailed instructions, and we must learn from them. When our Lord came face to face with the reality of the cross, he admitted that it was not an easy burden to bear. That's in Mark 14 verse 34. "There is only one way to pass the test of these present times: prayer." He went to pray and told the disciples to do the same, though not for him, but for themselves. In our memory verse today, Jesus said they should watch and pray so as not to enter into temptation, but they were busy sleeping. At a point, Jesus was so moved by their insensitivity to the reality at hand that he said to Peter, "Simon, sleepest thou? Couldest thou not watch 1 hour?" That's according to Mark chapter 14, verse 37. So we are being told today that it pays to listen to our guide, or to people we consider as our guardians in whatever walks of life, but especially in spiritual matters, and most especially when God himself, the supreme guardian, is giving us instructions. There are so many breakthroughs, so many opportunities, so many blessings that could have come our way, that would have been able to make use of, that we have not been able to make use of simply because we didn't listen to instructions, simply because we didn't do as we were told. The apostles also made the same mistake during their time with Jesus. Jesus was about to be crucified. He saw the weight of what was coming in front of him, and he knew that the best thing for that period was prayer. And he told his disciples that he himself was going to pray, that they should also engage in prayer. But when Jesus would come back from his prayers, he met them sleeping. And Jesus was so surprised at their insensitivity, and was even asking Simon Peter that, "Are you sleeping? Couldn't you just pray for 1 hour?" When God is telling us to pray, when the Holy Spirit is pushing us to pray, or pushing us to take a step, to do something, let us hearken. If he says we should sow a seed, he says we should pray, he says we should study something in our Bibles, if he says we should talk to someone, whatever he asks us to do, let us do that thing quickly and speedily, because God knows best. We do not know more than God. He knows why he's asking us to do such a thing. And even the prayer Jesus was telling the apostles to pray was not for him. He was telling them to pray for themselves so that they will not fall into temptation. Jesus knew what he was doing. How many times have we not hearkened to God's, you know, urges, to God's spirit speaking to us? How many times do we know the opportunities we have missed? Do we know the dangers we could have averted if we prayed? These are things we should look into and make sure that going forward, we do not disobey God's words or his urgings, or we do not disobey whatever he asks us to do. Beloved, to make it to the end of our Christian race, let us pay close attention to the details of the Lord's injunctions, and we shall be glad we did. When the Lord said, bring ye all the tithes to the storehouse. Malachi 3:10. He meant all the tithes. You do not need an advanced learner's dictionary to understand what all means. It is clear that in this case, all means everything that makes up one tenth of your income. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians chapter 11 verse 6, "For if the woman be not covered, let her also be shorn. But if it be a shame for a woman to be shorn or shaven, let her be covered." Here, Apostle Paul did not say much on why a woman should cover her head while praying or prophesying. However, a conscientious child of God would not press for too many details before she jumps at this simple instruction of covering her head while praying. We should learn to hearken to the word of God, whether it is convenient to do so or not. So we were being told that to end our Christian race successfully, we need to follow God's instructions. We need to follow the master. We need to follow whatever steps that have been laid down for us in the word of God or through the Holy Spirit speaking to us. And examples have been given as to some of these injunctions, one of which includes our tithe. The Bible says we should bring all tithes to the storehouse, not a part, not one-fifth, not a, you know, not a smaller amount than that one-tenth. Whatever constitutes one-tenth of your income should come to God's house. All of it, not a part of it. There's no need to rationalize it. There's no need to, you know, try to move things around to accommodate our own ideas. Whatever instruction has been given to us, let us follow it, because God knows best. If we reap the fruits of this Christian walk, let us follow instructions to the letter. Another that was mentioned was head covering. That the scriptures give instructions that a woman should cover her head while praying or prophesying. There's no need for us to try and rationalize all these things. Even if it's not convenient, let us do it because God knows best. Remember the case of Saul. After someone gave him an instructions to go wipe out some people who had been enemies of God, remember that Saul said, "Oh, the people said we can keep the animals for sacrifice to God and this and that." But God is not interested in partial obedience. He's interested in full obedience. And that thing cost Saul his kingship. So please, let us obey the word of God to the very last letter. Paying close attention to the details of God's instructions can make the difference between speedy results and delayed blessings. God asked Abraham to leave his entire family, and he obeyed, but not completely, as he took Lot, his nephew, along with him. The manifestation of God's promise in the life of Abraham did not come to pass until Lot separated from him, hearkening unto God. So another example that was given to us was Abraham. God told Abraham to leave his father's house and go to another land, but he took Lot along with him. He didn't leave Lot behind. And the manifestation of God's promise to Abraham did not come to pass until there was a separation between Abraham and Lot. In fact, Lot was a big problem to Abraham later on. God knew what he was doing when he gave Abraham that instruction, but Abraham was rationalizing, was trying to be too nice, and it delayed his blessing. So we may be experiencing delayed blessings simply because we are not obeying God to the letter, simply because we are not obeying God in full. Let us have a change of heart. Whatever instruction that have been given to us in the word of God, or that the Holy Spirit is dropping it into your heart personally as a child of God, follow every single word, and the blessings of obedience will be your portion in Jesus' name. Our prayer point says, "Father, please give me the grace to pay attention to the details of your instructions, even when I do not understand them fully, in the mighty name of Jesus." Lord, we are asking that you give us the grace to be obedient, to obey your instructions fully, even when it does not make sense to us, even when we don't understand it. Help us to comply, help us to obey, and help us to reap the reward of obedience in Jesus' name. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Thank you very much. I look forward to seeing you again tomorrow. God bless you.